morning, ladies. Today is the first day of week five. Is it crazy? Week five of distance learning. It's actually Sunday that I'm recording this, so I wore my mud hen stuff because it is 419 day. See? Happy 419 day. My production assistant over here again, coming to you from my family room, which, you know, I noticed in the last video, the K up here on my mantle was showing up backwards in the entire video and nobody ever said anything. So I switched that around. So it's actually a K. And today it's going to be pretty short intro video because we don't really have, I don't really have a ton of new stuff to talk about. So why don't we start off today with a prayer, pray a quick serenity prayer and keep everyone and our intentions who is who are suffering from this virus, who are working the front lines, and all of us who are trying to do our best to keep our sanity and stay at home and keep doing what we're supposed to be doing. So we're gonna say the serenity prayer. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Okay, let's start with AP government. So, girls, we are sort of in like the last final couple of weeks before the big exam. And this week, today, we're going to be wrapping up chapter five. Actually this week we're going to be wrapping up chapter five, and then starting next week we're going to go into solid review mode. We'll probably do seniors, maybe a couple more assignments where you're going to get graded, because I want to do another current event before you go. Probably looking at like maybe the end of the week into next week we'll be doing that as your final couple days with us approach, and basically again solid review. That being said, seniors, I know you're technically done on April 29th, which is next week from Wednesday. My thoughts or my advice to you is, you know, you can always, as much as I'm not going to be taking grades from you guys and all of your work has to be turned in by May 1st, I encourage you to any like reviews I like assign or, you know, send out there for practice, please continue to do that even though you're not going to be in school anymore, because I think that'll just be beneficial to all of you. Kind of keep that in mind as we reach the finish line. I'm going to be sending out a couple more reviews. My scanner was having some issues last week, so I didn't get a chance to send out the last Kaplan review, which is over, I think it's what they consider to be unit three, which is the civil rights and civil liberty. So I'll definitely get that up this week and get out some more stuff to you. So we'll just kind of keep doing what we're doing. All right, thanks. Okay, moving on to U.S. history. We wrapped up our unit on World War II, which is the unit we were working on before all this happened. And I just sort of kept things as normal as possible in terms of giving you some continuity of what you're used to, what we do in the classroom. So we're going to be starting, or we're going to be starting the Cold War this week, which normally if we were in the classroom, we would be doing a lot of group stuff, because this unit, it spans over almost 50 years of time. So I kind of pick and choose like important things, but we're going to start off today with doing a web quest. So you're going to be just kind of gathering some information about things that happened. So the Cold War is basically like starts almost immediately after World War II. And it's really the effects of World War II, how the US and the Soviet Union, who will be the two superpowers that you read in our last part of World War II, they emerge from the war. And of course, we don't agree with anything, the way our way of life, our type of government, our type of society. And so the Cold War is not an active war, meaning we don't like battle in a traditional war setting. It's really becomes a fight between ideologies. Okay, so you're going to be sort of learning a little bit in this first part about like the base the basis of the Cold War and how that begins. And then moving on from there, like I said, it lasts for a really long time period. There's a lot of different things that occur throughout that 40-45 year period of time. So some of which, like the Vietnam War, is technically part of the Cold War, but we're going to be taking that on at a separate time. And in terms of the rest of the class, as you know, we're not going to have exams this year, so yay, that's exciting. But there are still really important things that we have to cover before we're done with school, whether we're in the classroom or whether we're still doing distance learning. So we have to do the Cold War. We have to go over some parts of like the 1960s and 1970s, which is always a really fun unit because we talk about music and we talk about culture and we do some fun stuff that we can actually do if we're still distance learning, whether or not we're in the classroom. We also cover civil rights movement, and then we'll just kind of see where we're at that point. So those are some topics that for our state, meeting our state standards, because this is a course that you have to pass in order to graduate. There are some certain aspects of that that we need to cover. So it might just look a little bit different than we normally would if we're not in the classroom and we're still doing distance learning. But I think some fun things on the horizon, and I think that you will like some of the stuff we're doing, okay? So that is all I have for US. Hi, government. So these next really 3 days are the last days that we have together. I just sort of realized that when I was looking at my calendar, I was thinking that we had like 2 full weeks, but seniors, you guys are done on the 29th, which I didn't realize was a Wednesday. So we have Tuesday, Thursday, and Tuesday all together next week. So we're gonna be wrapping up chapter 13. With the presidency. So we did Electoral College. I hope you enjoyed the documentary. I think it's really informative and it's very entertaining to give you a little bit more info about that. We have one more thing to do with the presidency, and that's just the office in and of itself. So like, what does the president actually do? What are they responsible for? How does that all work? So I've sent out to you basically just kind of reading through the rest of that chapter and making either like notes, or you can do a chart, or you can do whatever you want for yourself in getting that information. So again, you can take pictures if you handwrite it and send it in, or you can do it on a computer, however that works for you, the government project. So what I would like you to do, ladies, this week, and I've written this in, or I'll write this on Classroom, is to send me your forms. So if you have done any hours, whether it's 1 or 2 or you did all 8, send me your documentation so I can get that, give you credit for that. I mentioned the like mini reflection. I'm going to be sending that out in the next couple of days. I am waiting just to get back with Mrs. Huffman. We haven't been able to connect at the end of last week, so just want to make sure that we have the same stuff for all of her classes as well, including you guys. So I'll be sending that out. It's just going to be a few questions. It's not really like I'm going to take you that long. And then you can get that back to me today. So seniors, I'll need everything by May 1st. That's sort of like your deadline for all of your classes when work is due. So even though you're done the 29th, you'll have like a day or two to get all of that in. What we normally have planned during these last couple weeks, which is our mock Senate. I know last week I mentioned that maybe we could still have that, but I just, with the time, I just don't think that that's gonna be possible. So juniors, we might do something with it, but we'll just kind of see. We'll kind of wait and see this week. They're supposed to make an announcement about schools, and if we're back on May 4th, I don't know, if we're still doing this to wrap up the course, we'll just kind of have to see what's going on for that. There are still a few things that, you know, we have to get done by the time the seniors go. So it's accredited because this is a course you need for graduation credit, that we get all of our stuff covered by then. So that's really all I have for you. And if you guys have any questions, let me know. And I think that's it. Thanks. All right. So, okay. Say hi, girls. Say hi. All right, so Murphy and I just want to wish you a great week. This is our sixth week of quarantining, or as Murphy says, the sixth best week of his life, because he doesn't have to be alone and he's got all of us with him. And what, our fifth week of online learning, I think that's what I said. So just, you know, keep doing what you're doing. You guys are doing really well. I know that it's tough. I know that it's not exactly what we expected to be doing at this point. But, you know, I think we're all just hanging in there and doing the best that we can do. So have a great week. I know that Friday was supposed to be make running. I hope that you still are able to, even though it's like April crowning, right? Because the 24th is April and not May. Hopefully you can still honor Mary in your own way. Think about doing something for someone else. Maybe if you and your family can think about donating to our local food pantries, I know are really in need of supplies. So think about maybe a way that you can do something as simple as that to honor our Mother Mary. I think it's a really cool idea. So, Murphy, can you say goodbye to the girls? Kaz is over here taking a nap. Oh, he kind of woke up. Kaz, say bye. And I leave you, as always, with a couple pictures of and videos of the dogs. You're probably seeing a theme here. They don't really like do much other than take naps and they, you know, play with each other. So we'll see you guys later. Say bye.
Listen, baby, ain't no mountain high, ain't no valley low, ain't no river wide enough, baby.
If you need me, call me, no matter where you are, no matter how far.
Don't worry, baby,
just call my name, I'll be there in a hurry. You don't have to worry,
cause oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough to keep me.